I used to be on top of the world, brother. All pro quarterback, 4 years running. Voted the sexiest Texan in 2004. Yeah, man, I beat out Dennis Quaid and Matthew McConaughey, for Christ's sake. Yeah, so I drank a few beers now and then, popped an occasional pill. That's nothing compared to what the team quacks to shoot me up with just so I could play. And sometimes I just need to numb the pain, you know what I'm saying? My biggest vice was speed. No, not meth, buddy, adrenaline. I blew every penny I had on the fastest cars I could find. Just so you know, I'm a damn good driver. If that asshole I was street racing hadn't sideswiped me, I never would have crashed. That poor girl would still be alive. That's right. That's right, it's his goddamn fault I shattered my leg in six goddamn places. So I had a few drinks in me, so what the fuck? I drive drunk better than I do sober anyway. Of course, couldn't play worse shit after that. After I got out of jail, I canned my ass, said I violated the morals clause on my goddamn contract. Ended up playing semi-pro in fucking Canada. But I'm still a name. Oh yeah, I'm still a celebrity. That's why they wanted me to promote their blood drive here. That's why they fucking flew me first class halfway around the goddamn world. Because my name still means something. Logan Carter is no goddamn douchebag. Useful.
Please leave your apartment immediately. Follow this is Hotel Emergency Broadcast System. Please leave your apartment immediately. Follow signs to the nearest elevator. For this reason, all elevators are offline.
See you through the camera. Feeling all right, mate? No shakes? Fever? Chills? Good. I'll introduce myself later. Right now, we gotta get you the hell out of there. Do exactly as I say, okay? You're gonna have to trust me. First, you need to get hold of a weapon. Search in the maintenance storage room by the end of the corridor. I would move if I were you. Now.
Let me open this puppy up.
Father!
Like I said, no, you heard what he said. You hear what's going on out there? You won't play inside.
I'm doing it. No! Didn't I bloody tell you?
No, stop! Wait! Hey! Can you hear me? Do you understand what I'm saying? Nod your head! Nod your bloody head!
I ain't asking you again!
Oh, thank God. I'm a doctor, not a bloody executioner.
Do you know how close we came to bashing your head in?
What the hell is wrong with you?
Those things came.
Why don't you do something?
See, boy, we're not to kill them.
There's nothing
to
fucking do.
Help him? You can't just let him die out there. He saved your life. You owe him your life.
You going out there? Are you nuts?
You're not gonna help. Get the hell out of the way.
You at least have a weapon? You need to find a weapon. All right, this is fucking crazy. On three. One, two, fuck it, three!
One? Okay then. Thanks, mates.
Are you there? Hello? Can you hear me? Shit. Hello?
We were just attacked. Listen, your friend from the hotel's awake. You were right about him being immune to this thing. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't have made it. Maybe now we can hold out until help arrives.
There is no help. This thing can't be stopped. I saw how it took my wife.
You need to get out of there, and I can help you. I can arrange for transportation. By air, by sea, but first you need to get here. To me.
I have many sick and injured here, mate. They're crazy with fear. Tell me where you are. Where are you? You there, mate? Hello? Hello? Oh, God damn it. We didn't think you were gonna make it.
You kill them all?
Okay.
No thanks to you.
Name's John Sinemoy, head lifeguard here. The voice on the radio told me you were in trouble at the hotel. Said you were resistant to whatever this is. I didn't believe it, but then I found you and I saw the bite marks. You got no symptoms, but... Those aren't love bites, are they? Look, I don't know who you are, or how you know that guy on the radio, but he's our only connection with the outside world. We keep losing the bloody signal. We have a monsoon coming. So here's the thing. We need to move everybody to the main lifeguard station. There's an ambulance there and more equipment and a stronger radio with an antenna. I hate to ask, but we can't do this without you. Will you help me?
I'll do what I can.
Good. First off, we need an access card to get past the security gate. Mine's in my room. With all the commotion, I forgot to take it with. It's in Bungalow 11, by the pools. Take a weapon and watch yourself. You may be immune, but that don't mean you can't die.
This is the end of day.
Why the hell did I stay here with Sinemoy? I should have listened to Maggie and left with James and the others. They probably found a way off the island by now. Maybe there's still time to find them. If you're out there and you see Maggie and the others, could you let me know where they are?
Sure.
Thanks. I'll be here. Because, I mean, you know, where the hell else am I gonna go?
It's in the Book of Revelation.
You don't know how it is you're immune to this, but we've got to take advantage of that.
This is fucking nuts!
Somebody's having a bad day.
Oh, my wife, my dad, oh fuck, my own fucking brother, Jesus Christ, what else could I do, let him kill me? Why are you looking at me like that? What the fuck do you want from me? I had no choice!
Anything good in here? Man, this hell looks just like paradise. To you, we might all just make it. Okay, ready to go out there again? I need you to find a lifeguard station and see if it's safe. Can you do that for me? I can't really turn you down now, can I?
Take the beach. It's the shortest way. We'll come as soon as we know it's safe. There should be a working radio inside. Signal us when it's clear, and we'll follow you.
Yeah.
next?
Oh, fuck. Fuck. Oh, Jesus Christ. If you hadn't come along.
You want to come with me? I'm gathering any supplies I can find at the water sports rental kiosk. Maybe you'll find something that'll come in handy.
There's a table inside you can use to repair your weapons.
Look, take whatever you want. I have to get some rest.
Somebody's having a bad day.
You
off!
Job, mates. We're safe now, thanks to you. But we won't make it long without food. If help don't come soon, we're gonna have to head to town. Meantime, maybe you could see if anybody needs help.
Hey, I'm Dominic. This piece of shit antenna's too weak to reach past the island. We need a signal amplifier to cut through the static. I worked on an antenna at the lighthouse nearby. I'm sure they got an amplifier there. We wouldn't last a minute against those things, but you, think you can get it for us?
Yes.
All right, excellent. You bring it back as soon as you can.
This baby needs some new spark plugs or she ain't going nowhere. Shame though, it's a hell of a car. A battalion of those freaks wouldn't slow this baby down. So, if you can find me a few necessary parts from any nearby wrecked cars, and we get this ride rolling, I'll let you take her out anytime you want. Deal?
You got it.
Excellent. You locate those parts. You know where to find me.
I heard this skirt. Urge came from outer space.
Can somebody... Hey, remember me, mate? I'm the doctor, but I can't do much without medical supplies. The door to the infirmary is locked from the other side, and Anne's in critical condition. You think you can help me break the bloody thing down?
Sure.
I appreciate it. Go on, then. On you, mate. Now let me get to work. What a bloody disaster. Nothing here at all, is there? We need to think of another way. Will you help me? I need you to locate an ambulance or one of the lifeguard vehicles. Inside, you'll find a paramedic bag with all the necessary equipment in it. I'm pretty sure I saw one by the Diamond Bungalows.
Yes.
Without your help, we'd all be 6 feet under by now. We're bloody walking corpses.
I'm telling you, it couldn't...
Kelly's worried about her husband, Will, but I think he's probably okay. If you happen to be nearby there, can you see if you can find him?
Yes.
His name is William. He's about 6'1", black hair, good looking. He's a concierge. He has a friend named Doyle who works in the Diamond District bungalows. I'm thinking maybe he's hiding out there.
I should have gone with James.
I ran out in such a rush, I left my necklace behind at the hotel. It's in bungalow 6 in the silver section. My husband gave it to me. It means a lot to me. I'm offering a reward. Can you help me?
Sure.
Thank you. Please, be careful.
These bodies are starting to rot. You smell that? We need to burn them before they start attracting more of these walking dead motherfuckers. Do me a favor. See if you can't get some gas from that station nearby.
Absolutely.
Okay, good. See if you can find a car. That way you can move more gas.